वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व लीट कोड प्रॉब्लम 213 हाउस रॉबर 2। सो लेट्स जस्ट गो थ्रू द डिस्क्रिप्शन फर्स्ट। यू आर अ प्रोफेशनल रॉबर प्लानिंग टू रॉब हाउसेस अलोंग अ स्ट्रीट। ईच हाउस हैज अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ मनी स्टैश्ड। ऑल हाउसेस एट दिस प्लेस आर अरेंज्ड इन अ सर्कल। दैट मीन्स द फर्स्ट हाउस इज द नेबर ऑफ द लास्ट वन। मीनवाइल adjacent houses have a security system connected and it will automatically contact police if two adjacent houses were broken into the same night. Given an array nums representing amount of money of each house, return maximum amount of money you can rob tonight without alerting the police, right? So this is what the problem is saying. So as you can see, when they are saying that return maximum amount of money, when they are like kind of optimization problem, right? So usually dynamic programming is a good way to solve these kind of problems. So let's take, like, they have given some examples, but let's take another example I created here, because this is a little bit like bigger array, so we can discuss more. So what they are saying are this is the houses, right? The houses, so house is like from 0, this is the index, right? 0, 1, 2, then 3, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, and this is 6. So there are total 6 houses here, right? 7 houses here actually, right? And what they are saying is the houses are connected in circle. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and after 6 again 1 is connected basically, right? So this is kind of a forming circle. So this is the first and this is the last, and again they are connected actually, as you can see. So this is the constraint they have given us, and we have to find out maximum money we can rob, right? So this is an important problem. This problem was asked previously in Google, Airbnb, Microsoft. So make sure you understand and know how to solve this problem. So let's go through the approach how we can solve the problem, right? So typically, if it is just a straight line houses, right, then what we do, this is a circular houses that is given to us, but typically in case of straight line houses, we always like, let's say, let's go through this example quickly. So what we do is we go here, first house, then maximum money you can rob is 1, right? Then when you go to second house, the maximum money you can rob is maximum between 1 and 2, which is 2, right? So 2 here is the maximum. And when you go to third house here, third house, then either you can rob this 3 and 1, which is 4, or you can just take the 2, right, which is previously robbed house. So that is how basically dynamic programming work, right? So what we are doing here is we are either taking the maximum as maximum will be equal to maximum of 2, 4, right? So 2 is the previously robbed maximum 2, and now with 3 and 1 the maximum can be 4, right? So we will take maximum from this basically. That is how dynamic programming work, and we keep doing this until end of the array, right? End of the houses basically. So so whenever, like, you are checking, you will check the previous one, what maximum you can find, and then you will try to check if the current one and the like previous to previous, right, means if it current is n, then n minus 2, right? If that total is more than the previous house, then you will take the maximum from these two basically. That is the approach that we usually like take for if the houses are in one line, right? So now they have given us here that the houses are connected in circle, which means that first house, this one, and last house, which is 6, right? So as you can see, so this 1 and 6 basically, right? So I took the amount here, but actually the indexes, if you take, they are 0 to 6 basically, the indexes, right? Here I just took the amount. So this is 1, 2, 3, and then 2, 5. So let me just draw this circle. This one actually, then we will just draw it a new circle. So it will be easy actually for you to understand. So let me just erase this quickly. Okay, So we will draw these houses in the circle, and then I will explain you like how we can solve this, right? So the first house will be 1, right? 1, then 2, 3, 2, as you can see here, right? 2. I am writing the amount here, right? Amount 2, 3, 2. I am not writing down the index, I am writing the amount 5, 4, 6. 5, 4, and 6, right? So this is like a circular way. The houses are arranged basically. So this forms a circle now, right? As you can see here. This is a circle, and 1 and 6 are connected. So the difference now, how we are going to solve, how, what is the maximum, and we cannot rob now 1 and 6, right? Because they are now connected to each other. As you can see in the problem, that there is a alerting system, and you know, it will contact police if two adjacent houses were broken into same night, right? So we cannot rob two adjacent houses, basically that's what it means. So we cannot rob 1 and 6. So what we will do to solve this problem is we will just start with 1, and we will like go until, so we will consider this array first. So this array, right? This is our array. This one will not have 1 and 6 adjacent, right? So this one we will consider, and we will fix like we will find a amount 1 from this one, that maximum amount we can get from this one, and then we will create another array. Another array means we will consider another part of this array which goes from 2 to 6, right? 2 to 6, and then we will find amount 2 from this. So this one is amount 2, this is amount 2 that we will find from second array, and from first array we will find amount 1 from here, right? And whatever maximum we will get from this, comparing these two, then that is the maximum amount we can rob in one night basically, right? So, and why we are doing that? Because we cannot consider 1 and 6 together, because they are now adjacent when they are circular, in the circular fashion, right? They are adjacent, so we cannot consider 1 and 6 together. That's why we are considering two different part of this array, and we will apply our dynamic programming on two different parts. So let us so the approach that I explained before, the same approach we will be applying here. So I just took the two arrays here. So this is our first array, right? And this is our second array. So in the first array, when we want to find maximum, what we will do is we will go from like here, we can find like the maximum will be 1, right? Because 1 at the first house, then when we reach here, the maximum we will find is 2, right? Because we will take maximum of this 1 and 2. Now when we reach 3, when we reach 3, at this time we will find maximum is 3 plus 1, which is 4, right? We will compare it with 2, so 4 is more. So 4 is the maximum as of now we found, right? At this point, 4 is the maximum we found. Now when we reach 2 here, 2, then we will compare the max, the amount that we find here, right? So 2 plus 2, which is 4, and 3 plus 1 is also 4. So basically maximum we can find 4 here, right? 4. And then we will go to 5. Now at this point, the maximum will be 5 plus this previous maximum, which is at 3, right? 5 plus 4. So it can be 9, maximum can be 9 at this point, right? And I'll just show you what, why it is 9, because this is 5 and we will add it to the maximum we found at this point. So at this point the maximum we found is 4, right? So 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. Now when we reach 4, the maximum will be this 4 plus 4, so either 8 or 9. So we will take 9, right? We will take the more amount that we can get, and that is what the amount 1 I have written here. So this is the maximum amount we can get by considering array from 1 to 4. So this is our part 1 of the array, right? Now we will go and we will choose our second array. This is second array, right? 2, 3, 2, 5, 4, 6. 2, 3, 2, 5, 4, 6, right? Because now we have to consider the 6, which is the last house of the array, right? So now again we will do the same thing. So at when we are at 2, the maximum we can find is 2 here, right? When we are at 3, the maximum we can find is maximum between 2 and 3, which is 3. Now when we are at 2, the maximum can be 2 plus this 2, right? What we found, or 3. So we will take maximum of 3 and 4, which is 4 here, right? So 4 we took. Now when we are at 5, we will check the 5 plus this, which is 5 plus 3, right? So 8. 8 and 4, so maximum we will say 8, right? Because 8 is more. Then we reach 4. Now 4 is 4 plus 4 again. So 4 plus 4 is 8, and this is also 8. So anything you can take, but maximum still remain 8. And when you go to 6, now you will take 6 plus this previous 4, 5. 5 means the maximum is 8, right? So 6 plus 8 is equal to 14. So 14 becomes maximum amount 2, right? So I just took the amount 2 here, 14. So obviously we will take maximum of now 9 and 14, which will be 14. So 14 will come as the answer for our this array that is given to us, right? Which is connected in the circular way. So that is the way we can solve the house robber problem by using dynamic programming. So let us just go and look into the code quickly. First thing is, like, we will check if the nums array is null or zero, then we will just return zero, because there is, we will just get a zero amount, right? If nums array has only one house, then we will take whatever is there in the one house, right? So that is what we will return here. Now if it has more elements, then we will just divide it from zero to previous from end, right? Zero to previous from end means zero to five, right? So we will just leave that last house basically. So that's what we are doing here, and we are calculating amount, right, for that. And here we are taking one to the end basically. One to the end means one to six, right? 1 to 6 basically, the last one is 6. So we are taking calculating amount for that array, and at the end we are just returning maximum of amount 1 and amount 2 here. So let us look into the rob money function. This is a function that is kind of a dynamic programming function. So we are passing our nums array here, and I and j, right? So in the first, the I will be 0 and j is equal to number of houses, like length of array minus 2, right? Means if, like, for example, the first array will be 0 to 5 and the second array will be 1 to 6, right? So that's what you will get, I and j. So first we will check if I is equal to j, we will just return nums of I. This condition is applicable when you have only like two elements, like 0, 0 for example, right? Then in that case I and j will become equal, so you have to just return nums of I in that case. And here we are creating the dp array, which is same length as our nums array, and we are saying dp of I is equal to nums of I. That is the starting point, right? So dp of 0 is equal to nums of 0 for the first case, and dp of 1 is equal to nums of 1 for the second case. That is the starting point. And then we are just going to calculate dp of I plus 1 will be I plus 1 and I, the maximum of that, right? So what it means is maximum between these 1 and 2, right? That is what, first and second element basically. Then that is dp of I plus 1, because these two elements we will require now, because we will be now looping in for loop, right? So to calculate dp of, let's say, dp of k here, for example, we will need k minus 1 and k minus 2, both numbers basically, right, of dp, so that we can calculate dp of k basically, right? So we will start from I plus 2 now, right? Because I plus 1 we are done here. Now we will start our loop from I plus 2, and we will go all the way until j, right? And we will just use this formula, right? So either we will take dp of k minus 1, which is like previous house find, right? Previous found basically. So for example, here 1, 2, 3 means previous found is 2 here, right? So if we have 1, 2, 3, let's say, and we are looking at 3. So 1's maximum is 1, 2's maximum is 1, and 2 maximum is 2. So we want to find out a 3 maximum. So it will be either 2. We can either take 2, which is maximum that we found in the previous house, or we can combine this 3 plus 1 and take the maximum of it, right? 4. So that is what we are doing here. So we are either doing maximum from the last, like previous house, or we are taking previous minus 1, means previous to previous house, plus the current num k basically, right? which means previous to previous, right? So like this is 3, so previous to previous means 1, right? So 1 plus 3 we are calculating here, so that 4 we are calculating and taking the max, and at the end we have to just return the last one, right? The last one will be our answer basically for rob money. So this is how we get amount 1, amount 2. We will compare amount maximum and return the result. So let us take the same example that we discussed here, 1 2 3 2 5 4 6. So we should get 14 here. So as you can see, the amount 1 we got 9, right? That we discussed here. So this is 9, and the amount 2 we got 14 here, right? 14. So we are just going to return 14, which is the maximum one, right? So now we will just make sure that these are the test cases that given to us are all passing, and then we will submit our solution. So all the test cases are giving us correct result here, 343, and here also 343, right? Yes. So we'll just submit the solution. So our code got accepted here. So this is a little bit like, because of this system out, I have to just comment this because I just was debugging. So let's just resubmit this and make sure. Yeah, so now as you can see, 100% performance, right? So 0 MS and then 42.14% on memory side, which is pretty good. So this is the way you can solve house robber 2 problem. This problem was previously asked by Airbnb, Microsoft, Google, big tech companies. So make sure you understand how to use dynamic programming to solve these problems. So dynamic programming is helpful when you have a kind of suboptimal structure, right? Means you can build the solution based on the starting point solutions, right? So for example, we first know zero, like we first know what is maximum of for the first house, then we know maximum for second house, and based on that information we can calculate maximum for third house, like that basically, right? So it, we can just expand on that logic basically in the dynamic programming. So if you haven't already checked my playlist for LeetCode solution, please check it out. It has over 100 solved examples from LeetCode and explained with examples and Java code. So please check it out. You will get lot, like all different kind of problems there, you know, related to data structures, dynamic programming, linked list, hash map, hash tree, tree map, all kind of problems are there. So please check it out. Also check it out the Java interview playlist, which has discussed frequently asked Java interview questions that were previously asked by big tech companies for their telephonic and in-person interviews and conceptual interview questions in Java. So please go through all that playlist. You know, if you are preparing for Java J2 interview, this will definitely help you, and it will help you in your preparation and your interview. Also, when you are coding, you know, make sure that you don't use IDEs. Try to directly hand code your solutions in Java, because many times in whiteboard there is no like ID or anything, right? So make sure that you can write a Java code without any ID. Also, if you like this video and if you find this video helpful, please subscribe it and like it. Your subscription is really important to us, because that is the way the video can reach to more people like you who are preparing for Java J2 interviews. They can also watch this video and get help in their Java interviews. So please subscribe, and thanks for watching the video.